Now let's say, for example, we say that consider that we are having a sphere, and there is a possibility that the extreme values are not on the boundaries, means on the edges, it is somewhere else. Then the average value will shift from the center toward that one or away from that one, depends whether it's a dip over there or it's a peak over there, mean maxima there or minima is there. So that is means just like is it was shifting the central point here and there, the same situation will occur with the sphere as well. And we will prove this thing now here. Over there we were not having any direct proof, especially in the two-dimensional case, but here in the three-dimensional case we can easily prove this thing. Let's say we are having a coordinate system, and the coordinate system is such that we are having x, y and z axis. So this is x axis, this is y, and this is z axis here. So in this one, let's say we are having a charge, and the charge is somewhere on the z axis. We can take this charge outside of the sphere at any point, but I'm taking it on the z axis in order to simplify the geometry to do the calculation a bit easier. So, but it is supposed to be outside of the sphere. Now I'm considering a sphere. I can consider a sphere anywhere in this coordinate system, but to ease the mathematics to calculate the things easily, I'm considering the sphere which is basically lying on the center, means the its center lies on the origin. So it's a sphere whose center is lying on the origin. And let's say now here, let me draw some points here. The distance from the origin to the point charge is z here, as it is along z axis. So I am considering the z distance, and the distance from this is, let's say I am considering any area element, because I will be integrating on area. So I consider area element, and this area element is dA, and from this area element, the distance from the area element to the source charge we usually represent with a tilted R, and the distance from here, from the origin to the point here, area element here, let's say this distance is R. And now I can, and the angle that which it is making here is theta. Now the geometry is ready, and we can go on for the solution here. So we are having, we are now calculating the average potential over a spherical surface of radius r. This is the spherical surface of radius r. This r is basically, when we will be integrating, then we will use this r, and when it will be integrated, then it will be from 0 to r, so capital R will come in here. And here I will write that is, it is better to write the integral, and we integrate in terms of theta, then I will write this as fix r. So I will not use dr, but when I will integrate over theta, then it will be d theta and d phi. So r will be fixed. So I'm averaging due to a single point charge, what is the potential on the surface of the sphere? And I'm going to calculate that thing. Now I know from my basic earlier calculation, as we did in chapter 2, that potential V of r is equal to 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught and q over tilted r. And what about tilted r? What tilted r is equal to? Tilted r from here is equal, if I use the log cosine, then r square is equal to z square plus r squared minus 2zr minus 2zr in cos of the angle. This is from the log cosine as we did in chapter 1st. So this is basically r square, and r square will be equal to this side square plus this side square minus 2 times this and this side and cos of the angle. So I can write this thing here that r will come out to be the square root of this. So I can write that 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught, or better I do write this thing in integral form. So this implies average value is equal to 1 over 4 pi r square, 1 over 4 pi r squared, and then V will come. So for V I will write 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught. So q over 4 pi epsilon naught is, there is no integration on q because it is outside of the sphere. We are integrating on the sphere. So we have q over 4 pi epsilon naught, and then 1 over r will come in here. So this is integration on a sphere, and r will come in. So r power will come minus 1 when I will write it here, and 1 over 2 from here. So this will be z square plus r squared minus 2rz and cos of theta, and this will have power minus 1 over 2 because r power 1 over 2 become here, and when 1 over 2 will go up from here, then we will have minus 1 over 2 there, and then we have here the value of q over this, and then sine of theta here, 4 pi r square. And then what about this one? This is the value of V1 over R value is here. So dA, the dA value I will put. And dA is R square sine theta d theta d phi. So as there is no integration on R, so I will write it in capital R square sine theta d theta and d phi. Integration is on d theta and d phi. So an integral is ready now. When I will come here and look at the integral, then I know that if a function is here and its derivative is here in front of it, then I can take the power minus 1 over 2 plus 1, and then minus 1 over divided by minus 1 over 2 plus 1. It's a simple rule of general integration. So here I will move this one. The r square is cancelling with this r squared. So it is gone. And I'm left with here. Now if I find the derivative of this one, and now the derivative here, this integral, it is on two things. D theta. D theta is from 0 to pi, and d phi is from 0 to 2 pi. So is there is no variable here involved with the d phi. So d phi will be integrated to 2 pi. 2 pi will come in here. It means that this one will go and it will just generate 2 pi here. While when I'm having this thing, then here is sine theta d theta. If I take derivative of this portion, then it will be sine theta d theta, but this value is also there, minus 2rz will come with this. So I will have to divide by the r2s because cos theta derivative is minus sine theta, so minus is compensated, and 2rz will be multiplied and divided in order to compensate this thing. So minus the 2rz in the top and in the bottom I will have to write, or you can write it in this way, that minus 2rz will be here, will be coming in. So I'm having q over 4 pi epsilon naught, and over the 2 pi will come in, and this will make this thing, the 2 pi will be gone with the 4 pi here, so only 2 remains here. So I can write that the average value of V is equal to 1 over, so here we are left with the q over 4 pi epsilon naught, q over 4 pi epsilon naught, and this 1 over 2, this 2 remains here. We will have to think, okay, I will have to write this 2 here as well. And then I need 2rz here in order to compensate this one. So 2rz will be here, and means after the derivative it will come in, and as 2 pi has already been solved, so this is the integral from 0 to pi, and z square plus r square minus 2rz and cos of theta for minus 1 over 2 and sine of theta d theta d phi. So phi has already been done, and as I have written 2rz here, so I will write 2zr here, because 2rz multiplied and 2rz here in order to have the function in its derivative in front of it, in order to make it easy for calculations. Now the integral is simple. Look here. When we will integrate this one, is it's a function and its derivative is here in front of it. So I will solve this one now like this. This is power n, so n plus 1 divided by n plus 1. Now what about n plus 1? Minus 1 over 2 plus 1, it will become 1 over 2. So it means this whole will become square root and divided by 1 over 2. So that 1 over 2 is simplified with this 2, and it has been cancelled. So I'm left with 1 q over 4 pi epsilon naught here. Q, this is equal to q over 4 pi epsilon naught and 1 over 2zr, 1 over 2zr, and here this is z square plus r square minus 2rz and cos of the angle, and this is having power 1 over 2, so I will write a square root, and this integration is from 0 to pi. So I will put 0 and pi here. Now let's see here this one as well. First, I will put this value phi. So it will become cos of phi. Cos of phi is minus 1. So it will become plus 2rz. So z square plus r square plus 2rz. Then hold minus, and I will then solve for 0, and cos 0 is 1, so it will become minus 2rz. So first I will have z square plus r square minus 2rz, plus 2rz, because this is minus 1, and here, so z square plus r square plus 2rz, square root minus z square plus r square minus 2rz, square root. So this one is basically, the first one comes out to be z plus r whole square, and the second one comes out to be z minus r whole square. So square square cancels with the square root, and we are left with v equals 1 over, okay, here 1 over 2zr q over 4 pi epsilon naught, and 1 over 2zr, and then it is z plus r, the square root and the square power gone with each other, and z plus r, and then whole minus, this is here, and minus z minus r, and it's here. So what this will become, this comes out to be z plus r minus z plus r. So it becomes z cancels in 2r. 2r goes with 2r, and 1 over z remains here. So the average v comes out to be 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught q over z. Now look at this average potential, q over z. Q over z is basically the potential at the center of the sphere, because it is the potential which is exactly at the center. We calculated it on the surface, and the potential came out is the average value came out the same potential as it is the potential from the center. So Griffiths, right? But this is precisely the potential due to q at the center of the sphere, and that is what we were claiming, that basically the solution of the Laplace equation gives you the average value, and for a sphere the average value is basically the center of it, and this comes out to be the potential at the center of the sphere, and this proves this thing. There is no local maxima or minima, and Griffiths is writing it to this one, QED. QED means that quad erat demonstrandum. That is what which was supposed to be demonstrated or which was supposed to be proved, and hence this is the proof. That we considered the charge outside the sphere, we calculated the potential on the surface of the sphere, and when we took the average potential, then the average potential came out is the potential at the center of the sphere, because this is the z distance from here to here, this is the z distance, q divided by distance, and this is precisely the potential due to the potential at the center of the sphere. And with this, we are done with the Laplace equation in three dimensions. In case you are having any confusion or questions, then you can ask in the comment and I will reply to that one. Thank you.